say that they are basically, you just look, follow one and leave the rest. No. In fact, the Quran tells Prophet Muhammad to follow Abraham and the way of Abraham and how Abraham lived his life, right? Because we believe they lived the same life, they had the same values, right? It was nothing different. But what happened is after Jesus was raised up to heaven, that people started twisting what he was saying, twisting the religion, twisting the tradition, twisting the scripture.
Yes.
And adding their own ideologies. Like when Christianity entered the Roman Empire, Constantine, the Roman Emperor, he is the one who introduced the concept of the Trinity in 381, the Council of Constantinople, and the Council of Nicaea, which is 325. He's the one who entered. Yes, he's the one who forced this idea on people anyway.
That's why even down to the Church of England was Henry VIII, and that was Roman Catholic. That's why it's all different types of things, each interpretation from their own ideology.
Yes, what about God? How do you see God? Like, we believe in a creator.
Yeah.
It's not like his creation.
No,
he's not a man, he's not a woman, he's not an idol, he doesn't come to die for anyone.
Jesus, best way to say,
Yes, no one can kill God, right? God doesn't die, right? So we don't believe anyone can kill God, we believe we're responsible for what we do. If you do wrong, you're responsible for it. If I do wrong, I'm responsible for it.
Yeah.
Everyone is responsible for his own actions, right? And we believe that Allah is self-sufficient, meaning he's independent and everything depends on him.
Yeah.
We believe he doesn't have children, he doesn't have parents, he doesn't beget, nor he's begotten, right? And we believe that there is nothing like unto him. As I said, completely unique. Anything you think about and perceive is not the creator. He's greater and more transcendent and beyond thinking anything you can conceive as a human being, right? So that's our concept. That's our concept of God, who we call Allah, right? Now, do you believe in the same concept or a different concept?
That I believe, that's the concept that I personally believe.
Good, okay.
That's kind of where my whole good to understand came
good
from.
Excellent. What about the prophets? We believe in the prophets of God, like Abraham, Moses, Noah, and the different prophets?
Yes and no. I was saying I've kind of got this connection between some of it.
Like,
we believe in the prophets, but I don't understand the stories enough to kind of contextualize it to really say those other things.
What do you mean by that? Like, I don't understand.
Just the stories, I'm not completely...
Like what? Give me an example.
Like, with Moses, it's the only reason I start saying the place because Jerusalem is an actual place. These are actual places, whereas somewhere along the journey, the connection between the people and the places and where we are here, for me, the story kind of got switched, where it starts making it out as a story, like a movie or a story, opposed to something that's actually...
Are you referring to the miracles that they used to do?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So that's kind of where I do believe in them, but somehow I'm still trying to kind of... You know, ground myself to recognize that was on this planet, that was here, that was missing.
Sure. What do you accept the idea that something miraculous can take place?
Yeah.
Like, because if you believe in God, right? Then by default, then you must entertain the idea of miracles,
oh, yeah,
right?
I do believe that,
yes.
Yeah.
Because why? Because God can do. He's all powerful, right? No problem. He's all powerful, so it means he can break the laws that he created easily.
Yeah.
He can split the sea, he can make an ark, all of this. So we as Muslims, we believe in these things because we believe that in the Quran. That's the reason we believe in these things, because the Quran, we can prove it's from God. And if we can prove it's from God, therefore if it tells us something about the past, then it is true.
That's kind of what I mean. And I think it's the things about the past, because it's so long since I started even being Christian and stuff like that. And everyone who was teaching was never kind of saying it to be a case of this is as it is.
Mm.
Whereas it was more make-believe story how they're telling you.
So when it comes to the Old and New Testament, there have been corruption in the scriptures.
Yeah.
So for example, like the Lot sleeping with his own daughters, we don't believe that.
Yeah.
Right? This is a story well known in the Bible, right? They got him drunk and they slept with their own father.
Yeah.
And he was a prophet. If I sleep with my own daughters, would you take information from me? Would you come to learn from me?
No.
Be the last person you come to learn from. We don't believe that's true. So we believe the prophets didn't do these things, right? We don't believe David sent a man to die in war so he can take his wife, you know?
Yeah.
We don't believe that. We believe prophets were examples for people, right? The whole reason God chooses these people is that we follow them and take their example, right? If they did these evil things, then we would do the same, right? But we don't believe that. We believe prophets sent by the Creator. Now, when it comes to the Quran, our Prophet Muhammad, do you believe in the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad?
Yeah.
Okay, if you believe that Prophet Muhammad is a prophet, and then the Quran was revealed to him, and he told us that some of these things that are mentioned is true, and then he negated the falsehood that is in the Bible. Like, for example, Jesus dying, we don't believe that. We don't believe he died.
Part which I've never been informed of.
Yes. The parts that are also illogical and irrational, things like that. Like Adam and Eve eating from the tree, and then the sin is for all human beings, right?
Yeah.
We don't believe that. Yeah, no problem.
I've got time. It's
only
5 past 9.
No problem. Yeah, no issues. So, what I want to say is this, right? Because what you believe is what Muslims believe.
Yeah.
You believe what basics of what a Muslim believes, right? To believe in Allah with his attributes and to believe that Prophet Muhammad is his messenger. That's the minimum criteria for someone to be a Muslim, right? Someone believes that he's a Muslim. If you go to the church and you say you don't believe in the Trinity, you believe Prophet Muhammad is a prophet, they'll kick you out, right? I don't need to tell you that. I don't need to tell you. So you wouldn't be a Christian from anyone's today idea or point of view of Christianity, right? Because if they believed like you that Prophet Muhammad is a prophet, then they would be Muslims. You wouldn't be Christians. Do you get the point, right? So your faith is a Muslim faith, right? So what is stopping you from them from following the faith and becoming a Muslim?
Nothing so far.
So you can become Muslim now then?
What I say is literally less than 2 weeks ago, my dad sent me an interpretation part of the Quran, so rather than the English translation,
yes,
you
yes. interpret. Yes, yes, yes.
So
yes.
He sent me that, oh, you got it on Wednesday.
Yes.
So what I say is literally last week this whole thing started. So
we believe in destiny. That these things, this is one of the articles of faith of Islam,
exactly.
Right? Yes, that the Creator puts these opportunities in front of you, right? You don't just come like this and you're just walking by. But there is a reason. So if you're ready, I'll tell you how to become Muslims. It's very easy. So testify in what you believe in already. If you testify and say what you believe in, then you enter into the faith of Islam, right? Then you can practice. I'll give you a few books on how to practice the religion. I'll give you my number as well. Take your number. And then we can keep in communication. So if you say after me, I testify.
I testify.
There is no God.
No
worthy of worship, except Allah. And I testify, the Prophet Muhammad is his messenger and servant. Now you say the same thing, but in Arabic. Ash, hadu, an, la, ilaha, illa, Allah. Wa ash, hadu, anna, Muhammadan, Rasul, Allah. Let's say you're Muslim. You see, it's very simple, right? Prophet ﷺ, I'll give you my number.
He's got the patience.
I don't think he was happy, right? But I'll tell you something.
On the drive here, I've done a 3-hour thing, the whole drive, I was listening to the video call about the same thing.
Oh, I'll tell you today.
A woman asked me to buy her food and stuff, but I wasn't going to. And then she said, groceries like veg and stuff. I would have spent £25 on just like potato, chicken, just food for her to actually
eat
and stuff. If it's buy you drugs, whatever, no. But to actually buy you groceries.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm telling you, this is not just you walking by. Look, there is so many, you know, thousands of people walk by us every day, right? The people who Allah gives guidance are those who love, who those who show sincerity, right? Because you believe in a sincere heart in Allah, you believe in His messengers, you have to be sincere, exactly. So many people are not, this is a problem, right? Some people you give them, if you show them the sun, they still don't believe is there. Do you get the point? People, they are arrogant, too arrogant to accept the existence of God. They say, why should I submit to God, right? Why should I submit to X, Y, and Z? Those who show humbleness are the ones that Allah guides, right? And you showed humbleness, so Allah Azza wa Jal, He guided you to accept His faith, right? So now you enter the faith. We believe any bad deeds you did in the past is removed, is wiped away. But from now you have to keep, you have to follow the faith, right? So Allah said, if you didn't know the truth before, no problem, I'm not going to hold you accountable. Now you became Muslim, now I'm going to remove the bad. The good is still there that you did, right? But from now you have to try your best to practice. So my advice to you is two things, right? Do you have a Quran? I'm going to give you one. Right. To read the Quran, number one, translation. Number two is to learn how to pray. Leave everything else now.
Tuesday, I'm going to a mosque with my Muslim friend.
Excellent.
He'd say he'll be along for the first time to hand.
Excellent. He will show you how to do ablution as well. Try to ask them to learn how to pray. Why? Take everything a step by step. It's a journey, right? If you jump too much, then you will get confused, right?
That's kind of what I wanted to do, because my siblings are Muslim as well. I'm one of 8 children, and 5 of them are Muslim. So it's, my niece and nephews are.
See, Amalia, like, you are.
Right.
Yes.
Half my family is Christian,
yes,
and half is Muslim.
Yes,
certain people like him, he doesn't get it, and I keep saying, he got with me in England.
Yes.
You don't know that side of my family, they're not in England.
So I'm saying,
I'm a big family. You can't understand. But
yes. No, I meet so many people like this, like you. I meet people who have half. Can you give me the new Muslim guide? I'll give you a few books now, right? A new Muslim guide, which is going to show you what to do, right? So look, you see here. Give me a bag, yeah.
This is kind of what I was trying to ask my dad when I was thinking, because you don't know where to begin.
Yes, to lead you as a journey, isn't it? Look, this is what you said. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This is a testimony of faith of how someone becomes a Muslim, which translates to our bear witness, there's no God except Allah, right? Then Then I will show you. Look, here is purification, which is wudu. The washing up that we do before we pray, yeah. Right? I will show you exactly how to do it, what to say when you do it, everything. In detail, right? So the meaning behind it. Here we show you how to pray, what to say, and the meaning behind it. Then you have, you know, you have five pillars, right?
Yeah.
This will show you the five pillars in detail,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, yeah. My friend was talking to me about it, actually. Yes. He converted 2 years ago.
Oh.
And when he converted 2 years ago, I was like,
I'm so sorry.
Yes. Some people are, yeah.
Yeah. I don't have much understanding behind it, but yes. Now I'm like, yeah.
Okay, let me give you these. Actually, let me give you one of these packs. It's better. So give it a read, and you have my number.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't hesitate if you
Ali.
Need. If,
yeah, yeah.
Yes, Ali. Call me Ali or Muhammad, up to you. Don't hesitate to ask if you need anything, right? We are here majority of the week, almost all the week, right? Don't call me, text me, whatever you're comfortable with. And then I'm gonna talk to you. Your name is what?
Mikhail.
Mikhail.
Yeah,
Mikhail, that's a nice name.